Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss gradually varied flow computations, which is one of the important topic because almost all major hydraulic engineering activities in free surface flow involve the computation of GVF profiles. Determination of the effect of a hydraulic structure on the flow pattern in the channels, inundation of lands due to dam or wire construction, estimation of the flood zone. All these type of problems can be analyzed by the computation of gradually varied flow profiles. The methods available for the computations are direct integration method, numerical method, and graphical method. In this video, we will cover direct integration method. And in the next upcoming video, we will cover other two methods, which are numerical method and graphical method. Remember, out of these three available methods of computation of GVA profiles, graphical method is rarely used, whereas numerical method is widely used because this is the only method available to solve practical problems in natural channels. The direct integration technique is essentially of academic interest because this method is applicable only for prismatic channel, and this method involve a number of assumptions. So now let's start direct integration method. In direct integration of gradually varied flow differential equation, the form of equation we use is dy upon dx is equal to s naught 1 minus k naught square divided by k square whole divided by 1 minus zc square divided by z square. In this equation, dy upon dx is the slope of free water surface at a particular section, s naught is the bed slope of channel, k is conveyance of the channel, z is the section factor. K naught represent the conveyance of the channel in case of uniform flow, and zc represent the section factor in critical flow condition. This equation is a non-linear first order ordinary differential equation. We have to find the solution in the form of y is equal to f of x, where x is the distance along the bed of the channel and y is the depth of flow. Means we for every value of the x we must have y value. The conveyance at any depth y is given by k square is equal to c2 y to the power n, and the conveyance at a normal depth of y naught in exponential form is k naught square is equal to c2 y to the power capital y naught to the power capital n, where c2 are coefficient and n is second hydraulic exponent. Similarly, the section factor at any depth y in exponential form is given by z square is equal to c1 y to the power m, and for critical depth zc square is equal to c1 yc to the power m, where c1 is the coefficient and m is first hydraulic exponent. Here it is assumed that for a depth range y1 to y2 for which we have to draw the GVF profile, the coefficients c2 and c1 are constant, as well as the first hydraulic exponent m and the second hydraulic exponent n are also constant. Now substitute the values of k, k0, z and zc in this differential equation of GVF. Then this equation will become, suppose this is equation number 1, dy upon dx is equal to s naught 1 minus k naught square is c2 y naught to the power n divided by k square is c2 y to the power n whole divided by 1 minus zc square is c1 yc to the power m and z square is c1 y to the power m. This will get cancelled. S0 1 minus y0 divided by y whole to the power capital N divided by 1 minus yc divided by y whole to the power m. Now let's take u is equal to y divided by y naught. Its differentiation with respect to y is du upon dy is equal to 1 divided by y naught, or dy is equal to y naught du. Substitute the value of y in this equation, and in place of dy we can write y naught du. So this will be y naught du divided by dx is equal to s naught 1 minus y naught divided by y is equal to u y naught whole to the power n divided by 1 minus yc divided by u y naught whole to the power m is equal to s naught y naught will get cancelled here, then 1 minus 1 divided by u to the power n divided by 1 minus yc divided by y naught whole to the power m 1 divided by u to the power m. We can write this equation in this form also, dx upon du is equal to y naught divided by s naught 1 minus yc divided by y naught to the power m 1 divided by u to the power m whole divided by u to the power n minus 1 divided by u to the power n. Or y naught divided by s naught 1 divided by u to the power n minus 1 divided by u to the power n minus yc divided by y naught whole to the power m 1 divided by u to the power m divided by u n minus 1 divided by u n. Dx divided by du is equal to y naught divided by s naught. This will go up, okay, u to the power n, and we are taking here minus 1 plus 1 and taking denominator separately, u to the power n minus 1 for this and 1 divided by u to the power n minus 1. Okay, minus yc divided by y naught whole to the power m u divided this will go up, so this will ultimately become u to the power n divided by u to the power m is u to the power n minus 1 divided by u to the power n minus 1, or we can write dx is equal to y naught divided by s naught. This will cancel out. 1, let's take minus out of this one, then this will become minus 1 divided by 1 minus u to the power n. Here we are taking minus outside this one, then this will become plus yc divided by y naught whole to the power m u n to the power u to the power n minus m divided by 1 minus u to the power n. Now integrate this equation, and after integration this equation will become x is equal to y naught divided by s naught. Integration of 1 with respect to u will be u minus integration 0 to u du divided by 1 minus u to the power n plus yc upon y naught to the power m. This is a constant term. Integration 0 to u to the power n minus m divided by 1 minus u to the power n du. Okay, and here this is the integration of dx. Now let's separately solving this integration. Integration of 0 to u to the power n minus m divided by 1 minus u to the power n du. Let's take v is equal to u to the power n by j, where j is equal to n divided by n minus m plus 1. Now differentiate v with respect to u. We will have dv divided by du is equal to n by j u to the power n by j minus 1. After substituting the value of j, this n by j will become n minus m plus 1. Okay, and after substituting here j value, then this will become u to the power n minus m. Okay, so dv is equal to n minus m plus 1 u to the power n minus m du. So hence integration 0 to u to the power n minus m divided by 1 minus u to the power n du will be equal to the value of u to the power n minus 1 is from this expression u to the power n minus m is equal to dv divided by n minus m plus 1 du. So this value is constant, so we can write it outside the integration. 1 divided by n minus m plus 1 integration 0 to v dv divided by 1 minus u to the power n will be, from this expression u to the power n will be equal to v to the power j. Clear? Here we are substituting the value of u to the power n minus m du. Okay, after substituting this value from this expression, we will have this expression. Okay, and u to the power n is equal to v to the power j. Now observe this integration and this integration, both are similar. Okay, here u is replaced by v and n is replaced by j. Now let's taking, or we can say calling, integration 0 to u du upon 1 minus u to the power n is equal to f of u comma n, and integration 0 to v dv upon 1 minus v to the power j is equal to f of v comma j. Now substitute these integration values in this equation, then the final equation will be x is equal to y naught divided by s naught u minus f of u comma n plus yc divided by y naught whole to the power m j divided by n f of v comma j. In this equation, f of u n and f of v j are called varied flow function, where f of u n is integration 0 to u du divided by 1 minus u to the power n, and f of vj is integration 0 to v dv divided by 1 minus v to the power j. This integration we can easily solve by using calculator. Now look at this equation. In this equation, the variables are only x and y, okay, and all other parameters will remain constant. So ultimately we have found the solution in the form of y is equal to f of x, means for each value of x we will have y value, or we can say for each y value we will have x value. In the next video we will cover numerical method and graphical method of computation of gradually varied flow profiles. Thank you.